Can you re-say your name?
Yeah, I'm Nitika from ABS. I wanted to ask you that if in the future you completely cut out the cell towers because of the radiation, do you have an alternative? I mean, everyone is using cell towers, so do you have an alternative?
See, if you cut off all of these cell towers, the southern rules are there by the government that almost 50 meters away from the nearest building, 50 meters away from the cell tower should be. So, cell tower, cell tower could be in some area outskirts of Bangalore could be, because the population there is not big. This cell tower is affecting our most of the population. So this is what we can do.
Your presentation is very nice. It was very interesting. Thank you.
Yes.
I just want to add, my name is Srikant.
Could you introduce yourself?
Yeah, my name is Srikant. I homeschool my children. So I have a piece of unsolicited advice. I think it's very interesting to make certain hypotheses, but as students, we should definitely test every hypothesis. So I think you made several hypotheses here about the ill effects of, or for example, flouting of certain regulations. So I would say put in a little bit of rigor. For example, to have cell towers outside the city does not make any sense because people live in the city. You need to have cell towers in the city, right? You need to have cell towers where people are, not where they are not, right? I mean, otherwise you will not have mobile networks here, right? And about all the, so I'm saying test every hypothesis. Then otherwise it will be a bunch of opinions, your opinions versus somebody else's opinions versus somebody else's opinions, right? So as students, I think we develop certain rigor and test each of these hypotheses and figure out ways to test each of these hypotheses. And then this is how I tested it, and somebody else will come and say, hey, this is another approach to, you know, disprove or prove that hypothesis and so on. This is a good first step, but I think you have to do.
So I think that one of the things that's really interesting is you got some data. Did the data come from...
I think what she's doing is she's collecting data, and you know, let's say that you have pollution from incineration sites. Of course, you need incineration sites in the city, but why are they usually put in low-income areas? So it would be interesting to study where exactly are these cell towers placed. But also, we know that we could historically say, of course, cars pollute, but you need to get around. But if somebody says we have to restrict the pollution, then you find ways of reducing the pollution. So there's always new technologies, ways of boosting things. We can look at what neighborhoods those cell towers are in. And I think what you were noting that he would say to kind of check on is, if people are breaking the law, it's not unheard of in India, it's not unheard of in the United States to have developers pay to not have development regulators. I think you need to test that and see, are they actually breaking the law? What were the actual distances that are supposed to be taking place? But I think that the thing I really liked at the end was using social media. So I think that you as young people, we no longer can go and march. I mean, we could, but I think our connections are so varied. But you can set up through WhatsApp or Facebook or blogs and find out who owns that tower and maybe start some kind of social media campaign to even get more information. Write to that cell tower, whoever owns it, and say, we're setting up a blog. Can you come in and join the conversation to answer questions? Get your local politician to get in there. So I think that there are ways of holding people accountable in really creative, socially transparent ways. And I think as citizen geographers that are cultivating geographies of care, how do we all become part of input?
Yes. And my kind of a comment actually. These students have taken up an interesting and also an important area of ethical issues of using technology. See, we all wanted a cell phone, but suppose rural children, there are hundreds of villages for which there was no tower. There was no tower connections available in the rural areas. Just to go after 40 kilometers from here or 30 kilometers from here, you don't have tower. So the market also, the market has to be seen very critically. So if they are taking up other PhD and higher levels of research, I think you find this area, this issue is a very critical issue for all of us. Because we all wanted towers and everything to be located in the where there is a market. So do you think that the market should locate it? Why all the cell phone operators should locate it in the city? I can also like, there are few areas, for example, all the 10 operators are located in particular areas. You tell them you go in some other places. Let one or two operators can be there. Why the market should allow everybody to have towers in such a particular area? The number of operators also can be reduced. The state government can take up action.
So we this can also see, the, area. We can see the geography, the density of the geography of cell towers as a geography of privilege and a geography of market. So if we want to just live a market-driven life, then we just let go. But if we also are thinking about health and education and so on and communication, should we be thinking about state sponsorship of cell towers in rural areas that will give people opportunities to communicate and find out what's going on in terms of markets in the city or what have you? So it raises a lot of really interesting issues. Does the medical geographer want to say anything?
I actually have a question.
Yeah.
So I'm aware of the ill effects of radiation, but I'm actually not aware of the avenues for filing a complaint officially. So could you tell us a little more about that?
Actually, the cell towers are taken by the students are working at the end. So we can complain if you have any problem, you can complain from the end. And that might be the same way. Any other questions?
Information and push in a different direction, right?
slightly to make people aware about that you have gone around places to do so many things. And actually I want to thank you for getting this here and making me more interested in knowing about that. Thank you.
So we've had a great series of sessions, and as always I'm just amazed at the level of participation and engagement, and I'm so amazed that we've got a homeschooling parent here. That is amazing. I commend you. So, is your child here too?
Yes.
In his room?
No, he's in another session.
Oh, I thought maybe he was hiding.
Yeah.
Okay, so thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you.